Hello and welcome to this week's episode of Bulldog Weekly. I'm Madeline.
And I'm Olivia.
In this week's episode, we'll introduce our new Harry Potter segment, take a look at some more bloopers, and the best moments from the 2019 Class Olympics.
But before we get into any of that, here's the week ahead from our principal, Mr. Duvall, and sports rundown with athletic director, Bill Tilden.
Hello everybody, it's the rundown. It's Sunday, March 3rd. We're into March. Very exciting. Monday, March 4th is day one in our cycle. We have visitors coming from Somerset Berkeley High School to see the Bulldog block in action, so everybody be on their best behavior. The phone-a-thon begins. It's the Booster Club's biggest fundraiser. It begins this evening in the cafeteria, and while we're calling it the phone-a-thon, it's actually changing platforms this year. It's an online drive rather than old-fashioned telephones. We're going to make the drive online and using social media, so please watch for that. We're trying to build the Bulldog Nation. Tuesday, March 5th, day two in our cycle. In the evening, Friends of Old Rochester Music is hosting the choral concert. It's an annual concert in our gymnasium with the choruses from all of our elementary, junior high, and senior high schools all performing that evening. It's a scholarship fundraiser. Wednesday, March 6th, day three in our cycle. It's an early release day, so we'll be out of here at 11:30 for students. Thursday, March 7th, day four, an hour delay. So we're getting you out at 11:30 on Wednesday. We're bringing you back at 8:30 on Thursday. There's a school committee meeting in the evening. Friday, March 8th, day five in the evening at 6 o'clock in our gym. The Hall of Fame, the Old Rochester Athletic Hall of Fame, is hosting their annual alumni game in the gym. Thank you, everybody. Praying for some snow. We need some snow. See you later.
Thank you, Mr. Duvall. Fantastic week in Bulldog Country. We've got playoffs going on. It's been a great week already. Girls hockey lost a tight one the other day. They were out and played Shrewsbury. A fantastic hockey team. We did lose 4-0, but it's been a fantastic season for girls hockey. Boys basketball beat Rockland. That was a fantastic game. The kids had a great time in the stands. I think the sixth man helped us a lot that game. We won 53-54 that game, and now we face Wareham tonight down in Wareham for our fourth go-around. So hopefully we can turn things around, get another win there. Girls basketball actually had a bye in the preliminary round. They got to beat Westwood last night. I think they were down by 7 or 8 at the half, came by, won by more than 10. So it was a fun game. They're going to play Falmouth tomorrow night at 6:30 if the weather holds. If we have to postpone, it'll go to Sunday, but we'll get the word out to everybody if that happens. Biggest thing happening right now, huge fundraiser for all our sports teams coming up. It's the Build the Nation. Build the Nation, our nation, Bulldog Nation. You're going to hear a lot about it next week. All our teams are going to help us out, try to raise some funds for the general Booster Club and for the teams, help us fix up some fields, get some equipment that we really need. So we're hoping for your help on it. So keep a lookout for that. We're going to have word out everywhere about it. So talk to you all soon. Thank you very much. Have a great day. Back to the Bulldog crew.
Thank you, Mr. Duvall and Mr. Tilden, for those informative updates. Now, onto a brand new and exciting segment.
In honor of Luna Lovegood's birthday, we decided to retake the Pottermore quizzes to see just how much we've changed throughout high school. Today, we'll be sorted into our new Hogwarts houses. Let's take a look.
Hi, I'm Maddie.
I'm Olivia.
My name is Mariana.
And today we are going to be resorting ourselves into the Harry Potter houses using the Pottermore website in honor of Luna Lovegood's birthday coming up. I am a hardcore Hufflepuff, I strongly believe.
I am a Gryffindor. Some of our traits are we're courageous, brave, and chivalrous.
I have already taken this quiz before at least 4 times, and I've always come out a Slytherin. And their attributes are being determined, ambition, self-preservation, cleverness, cunning. So I've always kind of been that, but we're retaking it because it's the end of senior year and we want to see if we changed over high school. So let's just get into it.
All right, moon or stars? The moon.
Dusk or dawn? I like dawn.
Well, I'm going to choose dusk. Because, like, who likes getting up in the morning? One. And two, everything exciting happens at night.
A troll has gone berserk in the headmaster's study at Hogwarts. It is about to smash, crush, and tear several irreplaceable items and treasures. In which order would you rescue these objects from the troll's club if you could?
First, a nearly perfected cure for dragon pox. Then, student records going back 1,000 years. Finally, a mysterious handwritten book full of strange runes. Well, I feel like that's the logical order already.
For me, I would probably go with a nearly perfected cure for dragon pox, then student records, then the mysterious handwritten book full of strange runes, because we don't know what the runes are, so they're probably not that. They might be important, but we don't know if they are or not. So you should go with what you know is important.
All right, which of the following do you find most difficult to deal with? Hunger, cold, loneliness, boredom, or being ignored? I'm gonna have to go with loneliness.
If you were attending Hogwarts, which pet would you choose to take with you? There's so many options. Tabby cat, Siamese cat, ginger cat, black cat, white cat, tawny owl, screech owl, brown owl, snowy owl, barn owl, common toad, natterjack toad, dragon toad, harlequin toad, and three-toed tree toad. Three-toed tree toad. Yeah, I got it right in the first try.
Well, is there any option to bring a dog?
I don't know which one. The tawny owls, I know, have like really big fluffy heads, so it's super cute. But then the snowy owls, they're just beautiful.
So I'm allergic to cats, so I can't actually bring a cat. However, I had looked these up previously, and my favorite one by far is the brown owl. If you look up a picture of it, they're the cutest. So I have to go with brown owl.
You can't like cuddle a bird or a toad, you know? No, I'm gonna go snowy owl.
Which road tempts you the most? The wide, sunny, grassy lane, the narrow, dark, lantern-lit alley, the twisting, leaf-strewn path through the woods, or the cobbled street lined with ancient buildings? The wide, sunny, grassy lane, because then you might find a field mouse, and that's adorable.
I like the cobbled street or the woods, I think. Because the alley, that's just sketchy.
Four boxes are placed before you. Which would you try and open? The small tortoise shell box embellished with gold, inside which some small creature seems to be squeaking. The gleaming jet black box with a silver lock and a key marked with a mysterious rune that you know to be the mark of Merlin. The ornate golden casket standing on clawed feet, whose inscription warns that both secret knowledge and unbearable temptation lie within, or the small pewter box, unassuming and plain, with a scratched message upon it that reads, "I open only for the worthy." If I know that it's the mark of Merlin, then it must be very important, right? And this one just has like some sort of creature in it, which is scary. I don't need to take care of anything. I'm 17. You know, we're just gonna go for the mark of Merlin.
Black or white? White.
Heads or tails? Tails never fails.
Heads or tails? Tails, right.
How would you like to be known to history? The wise? The good? The great? Or the bold?
I would go with the good.
I feel like either the wise or the good, because Alexander the Great was called Alexander the Great, but he was also a very bad person. I'm gonna say the wise.
Which nightmare would frighten you the most? Standing on top of something very high and realizing suddenly that there are no hand or footholds nor any barrier to stop you from falling. An eye at a keyhole in the dark windowless room in which you are locked. That was terrifying. Waking up to find that neither your friends nor your family have any idea who you are. being forced to speak in such a silly voice that hardly anyone can understand you and everyone laughs at you. That's already a daily basis. Have you heard my voice?
You enter an enchanted garden. What would you be most curious to examine first? The silver-leaved tree bearing golden apples? The fat red toadstools that appear to be talking to each other? The bubbling pool in the depths of which something luminous is swirling? Or the statue of an old wizard with a strangely twinkling eye? I would have to go with the fat red toadstools that appear to be talking to each other because that sounds adorable.
After you have died, what would you most like people to do when they hear your name? Miss you but smile. Ask for more stories about your adventures. Think with admiration of your achievements. I don't care what people think of me after I'm dead. It's what they think of me when I'm alive that counts. Yeah, no, because if you just don't like me when I'm alive, then that's sad. But if you don't like me when I'm dead, okay.
What kind of instrument most pleases your ear? Well, I'm biased, so if piano's an option, I'm going to choose it. Yes, it's an option.
If you could have any power, which would you choose? The power to read minds, the power of invisibility, the power of superhuman strength, the power to speak to animals, the power to change the past, the power to change your appearance at will.
That sounds like fun. I'm going to do that one.
Yeah, I'm just going to have to go with power of superhuman strength.
I'd have to go with, the thing is, I would love to say the power to speak to animals, but I feel like they would just go, hey, food? Yes. So I'd go, the power to change your appearance at will, because I think that would be pretty neat. I think it'd be more impressive than to be invisible.
I'm a Ravenclaw. Everything I know is a lie.
Hufflepuff. What can I say? Congratulations on being sorted into Hufflepuff.
Because my sister would always... No. No. I hang my head in shame.
Well, I guess I didn't know myself as well as I thought I did. Found out I'm a Ravenclaw. I'm not a Gryffindor anymore. I'm a little sad about that, but you know, at least I got Luna Lovegood on my side, and she's a lot of fun.
See you next time. We had so much fun rediscovering our Hogwarts houses. Almost as much fun as ORR students had competing in the Class Olympics.
Every year, ORR holds a Class Olympics before winter break. Students compete for their class in a series of field day events. Here are some of our favorite moments from this year's Olympics.
congratulations to everyone who participated in the Class Olympics. Now, on to our final segment.
Nobody's perfect. We all make mistakes at some point or another, and sometimes those mistakes can be hilarious. Here are some of our most recent bloopers.
Yay! We just filmed the introduction to bloopers.
Okay. Ready?
Mm-hmm.
Pen.
Arms and hunch over.
In this week's episode,
you want to know what I keep thinking of?
What?
Teachers and students, if you were a loved one.
That's exactly what was going through my head, and that's why I was messing up.
If you were a loved one.
If you were a loved one, I would like to have something filmed and shown you. At Bulldog Weekly, you better have mesothelioma. Otherwise, we ain't helping you.
RR. And da 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 da.
Yeah.
Yeah. Beautiful in the mic.
I would be so concerned if I were you.
And a sports rundown from Athletic Director Bill Tilden.
Teachers and students, if you were a loved one has been diagnosed with mesothelioma, I had to, at least one. If you're interested in joining the
sorry, I forgot.
Sports. That's it. We just cover sports. You can go home.
Started contracting dyslexia because that's definitely a thing you can do.
You can't contract it.
Hear the sarcasm in my voice, Olivia?
It's not herpes. It's not the flu. You can't contract it. Yes?
I can't drink with you staring at me.
Beat it. Oh, God.
Last day? I can't.
Yes. Informative updates. People keep choking on my ice.
Okay.
Okay.
Game master.
No.
It's like a thunder or lightning
storm. I understand
storm.
You. Yeah.
Why?
Yeah.
That messes with a person.
I only wear nail polish because I need something to do, and breaking nail polish off is better than doing nothing.
I mean, that is a reason why a lot of people do it.
Thank you, Miss Blah Blah Blah.
Today we'll see who.
Look, they're gonna. Hey, don't come in and write my lines on a piece of paper.
The paper to.
No.
Not to do.
No. All right. Not to do any of the above.
Okay. That was a lot of fun. Be sure to watch for more of more. Now I'm gonna say Game of Masters.
We know we're real.
We don't.
Okay.
I have this weird thing where if I paint my nails, I always peel off the nail polish on Thursday. Never before and never after.
Thursday.
It has to be on Thursday. And usually it's only every other Thursday.
You were close though. You were more than halfway there. You were doing good.
You were halfway there.
We're halfway there.
Whoa!
Okay, focus.
Okay.
All three interns working here at ORCTV are all psychic.
No, can I start that over?
No, you cannot start it over. It is illegal.
So students are run by members.
Yeah.
Just like a whole student mech.
Okay, are you guys in the back ready?
Yeah.
Heck yeah!
You may not realize it, but we mess up more. There's another one.
Today we'll learn a bit more about the cooking club while they bake shepherds into pies. Let's check it out.
Yes, I do.
Spell principal without looking at the paper.
Without looking at the paper?
Yeah.
You told me it's not the way I want to spell it, so it's P-R-I-N-C-P-A-L.
Yeah!
Yeah.
It's because I want
to... Guys, she learned how to spell principal.
I want to spell principal as in like principal, like a principal.
It's a principal.
Science, but it's a principal.
Game Masters. Be sure to watch for me, the Game Master, in the next episode.
I'll heal the gay gods. Hey.
Wait.
What?
Okay, I wanted to.
Oh.
But that's cool. No, I was gonna pat your back.
Oh.
Good?
Yeah, I'm fine. That's not how you play Uno!
No one to our final segment.
Okay. Ribs.
Okay, I'm ready.
Let me look at my line.
I'm letting you look at everything. I did not remove your eyes from your head.
So, Old Rochester Community Television now has its own office line.
No.
Okay.
Good job.
Thanks.
You have bad pasta.
Okay. Ready?
Look, it's like a pterodactyl's foot.
Yes, it is. I'm waiting for your cue. Oh, I forgot I can infinitely crack my middle fingers.
Oof.
Oh.
Yeah?
Here's a brief PSA from the junior high nurse. Oh.
No! Ready. Anchor powers unite.
What?
Anchor powers unite.
We need rings.
I already have one.
I can't flip people off now.
Your donations help save a life.
I'm sorry, my phone went off and I just started laughing.
Someday. When I'm feeling low, just thinking of you and the way you look tonight. Do 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 do. All right.
It's not a good word for you.
Familiar. So many vowels.
Not looking at you. I am looking currently at Mariana, who takes anatomy, who is through the camera, and also one of you, but not exactly one of the 20 that has accidentally scrolled upon our channel.
My throat does this thing where, like, I can't burp, so it makes, like, weird noises.
Did you guys hear that?
Take it from Maddie's line.
I know. I feel like I'm too close to Maddie.
No, it's probably fine.
Did I move?
No, hold still, there's something on you. I'm sorry, I haven't had it.
This winter season has brought with it a nasty strain of the flu. Here's a brief PSA from the school nurse. Oh, wait, no, crap, no. Get off my desk.
The best of most. Here's some of the most exciting moments from this season. What, did you need that page?
On to us, dude. Oh my god, we gotta get out of here.
Hide the weed.
Hide the sticky icky.
And sports rundown. I can't.
I'm sorry. I have a habit of, like, when I see something on someone, I just reach over. It was like a black dot.
black dot on me?
Yeah.
And like, was it a freck? Oh.
No, it moved when I touched it.
Oh no.
Teachers and students, if you would like to have something filmed and shown here on Bulldog Weekly, let us know at the ORC TV station.
Be sure to check out our Vimeo channel for everything we film here at ORC TV. We cover sports games, town meetings, school events, and so much more.
Well, that wraps up this week's episode of Bulldog Weekly. Until next time, I'm Maddie.
And I'm Olivia.
And this is Bulldog Weekly.